Michael, what did you do before you joined Evergrey, and what do you do when you grew up?
Well, I've been playing in a couple of different bands before I joined Evergrey. Different constellations, totally different kind of music. When I joined Evergrey, I saw it as a, you know, something that would gain me as a musician to start playing different kind of music than I was doing before, you know, to make a wider spectrum of my musicianship. So I mean, music has always been a big part of my life. I started playing in band when I was 15.
I heard the first instrument you played at school was the flute. How did that transform into a heavy metal bassist?
Well, it's pretty common here in Sweden that, you know, when in second grade you start to play the flute, and I have no idea why it's the flute, but that's how it is. And you do that for 1 or 2 years, I can't remember, and then you have an option to continue with whatever instrument you want to play. So I started playing actually the contrabass after that. I only did that for a year, but you know, I've always wanted to, you know, since I was pretty young, be in a band and be a bass player in a band, so it just came natural to.
And what would you say were your biggest influences in terms of bands and music styles?
I mean, what really influenced me to start, you know, really focusing on music was bands like Metallica, Skid Row, AC/DC, Kiss, of course, and you know, but nowadays, you know, I see myself as influenced by everything that, you know, gives me something. You know, all the music that I like is influencing me to keep on doing what I do.
What was the last record you bought?
That was actually Demigod by Behemoth.
Did you like it?
I love it.
What's your favourite of the Evergrey albums, and which is your favourite song?
I would say it's... I've been thinking about that a lot. You know, it's hard to pick a favourite album because, you know, of course I've played on three of them, and of course they're very important to me, but I still see, you know, the first album, The Dark Discovery, is when I heard that the first time, it was just something I've never heard before. It was just so totally different from what I listened to at the time, and so it just grabbed me instantly.
Mm-hmm. And what's your favorite song?
My favorite song is actually, at least for the moment, is what I think is a very underrated song, Visions, on the last, or on the...
Should you do that again?
Yeah.
What would you say was your favorite song?
For me now, at the moment, it's the song Visions. For me, that's a very underrated song. A lot of people thought it was one of the weaker songs, but I think it has, you know, so many different elements. It's got the heaviness, the emotion. You know, for me, it's a fantastic song.
A few questions that fans have sent in. Dries Doctor from the Netherlands sent in a question that made me quite curious because I was there too. During your Prog Power 2004 gig in Barlow, you went off stage and it took a while for you to come back on again.
Yeah.
What was the reason?
Well, that show was, I don't know, maybe a month after I was in an accident with my motorcycle. So I was still having some problems with my hip after that. So something happened during the show and I couldn't stand anymore, so I had to get off stage.
Pretty quick.
Yeah.
And Rob Lafleur from Ontario in Canada is curious to know, if you were offered a chance to audition for Metallica now, would you?
No, I wouldn't.
Why is that?
Well, nowadays they don't represent anything that I would want to do music-wise, so...
And somebody else wants to know, if you were a porn star, what would be your favourite position?
Well, my favourite position... If I was a porn star. Well, I mean, that's a tough one. They're all good. They're all pretty good.
You're not fussy.
Huh?
You're not fussy.
No.
You and Henrik seem to be having some sort of tattoo endorsement deal going on at the moment. Would you care to tell us and show us a few of your tattoos and explain what the attraction is to having tattoos done?
Well, I've started. It's not that much work done yet. I'm starting. It's traditional Japanese Bushido style. And this is start of one arm, and it's going to evolve to a full bodysuit in Japanese Bushido style.
So the full of your top?
Yeah. The entire body.
Yeah. How long will that take?
Well, probably until I'm 40 or something.
And what's the attraction with it? Is it a personal thing?
Yeah, I've always, you know, loved the pictures you see especially in Japan, it's like old labor men. They have, it's pretty common, they have full body suits. And so I've always loved that style, and that's what I'm going to do.
And what's the story I've heard about you lying in a hotel corridor with a do not disturb sign on your nose?
Well, that must have been the first prog power we did in Holland. We were drinking quite heavily, as we tend to do. And we ended up at the hotel, and I stayed in the lobby drinking with someone, I guess. And I had no clue what hotel room I had. So I was, you know, wandering around, just trying to find my room. I don't know how we do that, but so I don't know. I must have just laid down to sleep on the floor, and somebody put the sign on my nose.
No, this live album is the fourth you recorded with the band. Do you feel Evergrey has now become as big a name as it's going to be playing this sort of music, or is there still room for the band to go further?
No, I mean, I don't see that there's any limitation for how big Evergrey can get, you know, because of what genre or kind of music we play. We seem to attract more and more people all the time, so I definitely think that there's a lot of more work for us to do.
And what should you, as everybody goes through their life journey, what is your biggest thing that you've got out of being in Evergrey? Is it, what has it changed with you or brought to your life?
Yeah, I mean, I've been able to see the world, and of course that gives you a lot of, as a person, to see different parts of the world. And I've been, you know, fortunate enough to do what I love, which is play music in front of people who appreciate what we do. So
good. And last question, well, not so much a question, more an observation. As you know, as part of this DVD, the band invited fans to write in with questions. And there's one I'd just like to read you. It's more of a comment from somebody, but just to get a reaction from. This guy called Adam Bonilla Morales, hope I pronounced that right. He's a 20-year-old from Mexico City, literally quite some distance away from, yeah, and a bit warmer, hopefully, than we're in Sweden today. He says the following: maybe a lot of people in their whole life will never know why they hear your music. The thing is that you have reached the deepest place in my heart with that touch of humanity and sensibility. Thanks to all of you. You have helped me to get over so much. We become your fans for what you make us feel, how you can do this magical thing that is to transcend so deeply in our mind and in our heart in such a beautiful way. It must be pretty cool to get that sort of reaction from somebody from what you do, what you create, literally the other side of the world.
Absolutely. I mean, to be able to touch someone with the music that you create in that way is, you know, that's the best, you know, evidence you can get on, you know, that what you're doing is a good thing, that what you're creating, something unique, something good.